1-0 defeat at home to Pats. You must be really disappointed.
Yeah, we're disappointed, obviously. You know, St. Pat's are a good side. They won the cup last year. They won the league the year before with more or less the same group of players. You know, they put us under pressure in the first half. I thought they were quicker and they moved the ball better than us. And their anticipation, they picked up the second balls a little bit quicker. So, you know, we're a little bit disappointed at half time with the performance. We addressed it somewhat at half time. I thought we were a lot better in the second half without having any huge amount of quality. You know, we didn't get the ball down the sides of them. We didn't get the ball wide quick enough, and we didn't get the ball into the box. You know, particularly when we brought on Jason and to go 4-4-2. So. You know, I know we can play better. We won't always be playing St. Pat's. So this team, you know, they've worked really hard so far this season. We can have no arguments, no complaints. And, you know, we just can't feel sorry for ourselves now. We've got to pick ourselves up and dust ourselves down for Sligo away on Monday.
Pat's a very good footballing side, you know. And I think we're going to do more into it in the second half, you know. We were disappointed not to get the draw, like, but it's just the way it goes, you know. We'll have to respond quickly, you know, on Monday and on Friday next week.
You're unlucky with the goal itself. You saved the initial shot, but yeah. The rebound was cruel to you.
And Derek Prendergast slipped as well. He told me that he was getting to the rebound as well. But them things. Sometimes things go for you, and sometimes they don't. You know, I think over the course of the season, hopefully they go your way. You know, it's I guess it's like penalty saves as well. Sometimes you guess right, and sometimes you don't. You know, so.
Speaking of penalty saves, could have been 2-0 had it not been for you keeping out Killian Brennan.
Yeah, well, he done that to me last year. He sent me the wrong way. So, I mean, it's the only thing that I went off. He kind of sent me the wrong way last year. So I said, no, I'll go the same side. And luckily enough, he went that side. So it was happy days. Kept us in the game and thought we might have sneaked the draw in the end, but it wasn't to be.
Derek Prendergast is clearing the ball off the line all day long. Even if it was going in, he slipped and it allows their player for a simple tap in. You know, I think in the build up to the goal though, we got to have a look at that, because Forrester was given too much time and space in the middle of the park to play a penetrating pass. So, listen, they're a full time side. They've got good players, but we've got some good players too. I think I thought we lacked a little bit of belief in the first half. You know, so you know we deserve to be there where we are in the table at the moment. You know. The results, you know, have proven that. So, you know, we just got to make sure that this is only a blip. We'd like to think we can go to Sligo and put in a good performance there. If we do that, we get something from the game. So, you know, listen, tonight is what it is. We have to move on. We can't feel sorry for ourselves now.
We've only conceded 4 goals this season. I mean, that's testament to both yourself and the defence that yeah. Pretty much a new defence.
I think we're very experienced at the back, though. You know, if you look across the back four, you've Larkin and Derek Pender, the fullbacks, and then you have the centre halves with Anto and Derek, and the likes of Young Bestie coming in is done very well, and Dave McCarthy can slap back there as well. So it's very experienced back four. I think that stands us in good stead in most of the games, you know. When the likes of Bestie came in against Rovers, young lad coming in, and he was brilliant, you know. But it was probably to do with an awful lot of talking with the lads as well, you know, telling them what positions to be in, and that kind of stuff stands you in good stead as well, the experience side of it. So, it's not just me, it's the rest of the lads as well. It's been a great effort from us, but we're looking at it now saying it shouldn't stop. We keep going as long as we can in the season to get as many clean sheets as we can, you know.
Yeah, well, Dean has made important saves at crucial times in games. You know, he's kept clean sheets. He saved 2 penalties. So, you know, we're really pleased. And pleased for Dean. He works very hard in the training. He studies the game. He's that type of man. He thinks about the game. So we're pleased for him. But, you know, listen, you know, that's what he gets paid to do as well. He keeps goal for us and he's doing a really good job.
Are you enjoying your football? You've been having a great season. Yeah. You've been singled out for a lot of man of the match performances in the past few games.
Yeah, it's gas. Ironically, like throughout the whole game, you won't have much to do. And that's the saves that kind of make it or break you. In another way, luckily enough, this season now it's come together. I mean, since I came here, it's been a slow progression of getting better each season. And it was something I was really determined to do this year is to be focused on and basically tick all the boxes and have no excuses that. You're not doing the right things, you know, that way, whether it's eating or stretching or seeing your physio or taking the day off, you know, here or there. I think as you get older, you get box a bit cleverer, you know, so maybe that's all clicked this year for me, so that'll let me continue.
Yeah. Our next games now are both away to Sligo on Monday and then Derry. Do you feel that the team will bounce back?
Yeah, I think because the game is so soon on the Monday that there's no time for, you know, sulking or wishing what might have been in the game tonight. But we would have looked to get a draw, and then maybe if we just need to result out of the other two games, another win maybe would have kept us right in the pace of things. But no, look, we'll go out there on Monday looking to get a result, and the same on Friday. And if we do, you know, it keeps us in amongst it. So we'll be looking forward to the two games. Yeah.
Are we going to bounce back from this?
Yes, we got to be positive. You know, this group deserve, you know, they've done well. So tonight is a blip against a good side, and we can go to Sligo and we can get a result in Sligo on Monday. Obviously, we've got a tough week. We've got to turn around and go to Derry on the Friday as well. So this is a measure of us. It's a real test for us. So we'll see what we can do over the next week.